Hello everyone, thanks for watching this Tips for Swips video. My name is Mike Callahan, I work for WGR. I will be telling you today about the 303D Watershed Impairments List. So this is in our SWIP template. We have a pollution narrative and we will be listing out the 303D list impairments. We will not be going over the TRI reporting chemicals or the attachment E TMDLs in this video, and we'll be covering those in other videos. So, the 303D list, what is it, where can we find it, all that stuff. We're going to need to go to the State Water Resources Control Board website. From there, you're going to want to go to the Industrial Stormwater Program section. In that, you can find the new Industrial General Permit. You're going to want to download this to save you time later. So, once you go to the industrial permit, I have mine here to save us some time, you're going to want to go to the bottom of the permit. That's where we're going to find the information on the 303D list. You can either do this with the scroll bar or by hitting the end button, which is next to your delete button on your keyboard. Go to the very last paragraph, and it talks about the Excel spreadsheet containing the water bodies with 303D impairments. To view the attachment from this electronic PDF version, left click on the paperclip icon to the left of this PDF file. Here's the paperclip they're talking about. If you click on it, it then gives you all the attachments for this general permit. We want the last one. This is the 303D spreadsheet. Again, you're going to want to download this because this will save you time in the future. So I've already done that. And here's this scary looking 303D list. How do we start? Well, the first thing you're going to want to do is narrow your search with this, the region name. If you don't know the region that your facility is in, you can go back to the State Water Resources Control Board website and they actually have a map. So to find this map more directly, you can either pause the video now and copy this web address or by clicking on the box at the bottom of the video. So, here's our map of California with all of the regions. You can either type in the address of your facility here, or if you know where it is, our hypothetical company is actually in Lodi, California. You can just zoom in on the map. So there's Stockton, there's Elk Grove. Here's Lodi. So Lodi will be in this purple region. Left click on the purple region and it'll give you the information about it. So this is the Central Valley Region Water Quality Control Board, specifically the Sacramento office, but we don't need that for our 303D list purposes. We just need that it's the Central Valley. So go back to your 303D list, click the region name tab, and then to operate this scary looking checkboxes, you're going to want to hit select all. This will unselect the inappropriate regions, and then you just select the ones we need. So ours is Region Board 5, Central Valley, and hit OK. This will then narrow our search. Now, what you're going to want to do, or this is what I do, is I create a separate document with all of our facilities' impaired waters. You find these impaired waters from the HUC 10, which we actually talk about in our HUC 10 video. So I would go check that out first if you haven't yet. So for our company, the only one we have is the McCallany River. If we had more, I would list them here. So going back to the 303D list, you'll go to the water body name, hit the same looking button, which gives you this big scary list again. Hit the select all to unselect all the ones we don't need and start searching for your water bodies. So there it is, McCallany River. This will have all of them selected again sometimes, so you're going to want to unselect all the inappropriate ones and just select the ones we need and hit OK. This will then bring up only the information about your water body. The information we're specifically interested about is this column here, the pollutants. So you're going to want to copy this column by left clicking and dragging over the whole thing. See here, this in red? We're not going to need this because we can't search for an unknown toxicity, but I just copy all of it anyway. copy. I go to the document I created earlier, and then you're going to want to paste it. Now, the problem is if you paste like normal or just use the keyboard shortcut, it'll copy it with all of the information, including the big old ugly boxes that we got from the Excel file. What we're going to want to do is go to the last option, the one with the little A on it, because that'll just copy the text, and that's all we need. So now that we have just the impairments, we can find unknown toxicity because it was in red, delete that, and now I split the screen to make it a little easier for me. So I'm going to split this to the left, and then open my SWIP. I'm going to split it to the right, and now we have all of our impairments. I'll copy them here, the new list without the ones that are in red, and then paste them into my SWIP in the appropriate section. Again, you don't want to just paste it like normal and it could mess up your formatting. Pasting with just the text will keep the formatting that you have in your document. So if there is any other water bodies in your HUC 10 or for your facility, you will have multiple more lists of impairments. You don't need to copy all of them in and have multiple of the same chemical or same impairment multiple times. You just need to take all of the unique ones and put them into your SWIP. And then that's all that there is to it. Thank you for watching this Tips for SWIPs.